Sometimes you want to download a program or an operating system where you can create a bootable disk rather than ordering it online and waiting for it to ship to you. Everything's online now and downloadable, but not everything is an exe file or executable that you can just download and run it right from there or copy and paste that to a disk. If you want to make a bootable disk, there's different ways of creating a bootable disk that you can then insert files onto, but one of the greatest things is creating or downloading an ISO file. For example, if you want to create a bootable disk for Windows or for Linux, then you need to use an ISO file. Otherwise, just getting the files, extracting them onto a disk would not make it bootable by itself, and therefore it's useless. So in this video, I'm going to show you how easy it is to burn an ISO file in Windows 10 to a CD or a USB drive. So stick around. So since this video is a prelude to another video on installing and running Linux, I'm going to show you where to find an ISO file, such as a Linux bootable ISO file, and how to download it and run it from there. So let's have a look at my screen. So if you go to linux.org, and on the top menu here, there's Download Linux. It takes you to this page. And here you'll see a bunch of different versions of Linux, so you can get a good taste of how many flavors of Linux there are out there. And I haven't tried them all, but I can tell you that I've looked at Ubuntu. Linux Mint I found was my favorite for a long time. Xubuntu is a spin-off of Ubuntu, but it has a nicer user interface that we're going to look at. And Red Hat has been a popular one known that has support included, because most of these are free operating systems, but Red Hat was one that you would pay for and you get support for it, which is great. And there's quite a few. I think I played with Kubuntu once, and Kali Linux is one. Security penetration testing and that, so security experts would use that for testing network security, but unfortunately the bad guys use this as well. So in the downloads here, where did we want to go? Xubuntu. And here it shows the latest release version and what they call it. They always have some kind of fancy name for it, just like Microsoft has for their Windows releases. And the first option here is from the torrent downloads, choosing a 64-bit or a 32-bit. Now, if you already have some kind of torrent program for downloading torrents and extracting the torrent files, it's going to be an ISO file embedded in a torrent file. So it's almost like a zipped file that you're downloading, and you would unzip it and then you have the ISO file. But the zip is actually a torrent. So if you know torrents, go ahead and do that. Otherwise, I don't play with torrents. Torrents are typically associated with viruses now, and I don't like that. I'm not going to screw around with it. So if we go down further here, there's mirror downloads. And it tells you here, if you don't know how, or I would say if you don't feel comfortable with using torrents and you don't want to download another program unnecessarily, then choose one of these options. So choose what's closest to you. And when you go into that country, you're going to see a whole list of overwhelming options here. Now, it's really not that difficult. If you start looking at Xubuntu, you see the version number 18.04.04.1.2.3. So the latest ones are 18.04.03, starting from here. There's still a bunch of options to choose from, but from here you can choose if you're on an AMD type processor. They have torrents, syncs, lists, manifests, metalink. Don't worry about those. We just want the .iso. So if you're on an AMD 64 processor, then you would choose this one. If you're on an Intel, there's the i386.iso file. So don't worry about these, because again, the torrent would be like on the previous page. So I have an Intel processor, so I'm going to choose this one. So it's the Xubuntu 18.04.3, and it's for the Intel platform, and it's an ISO file. So I'm going to save this, and it takes a while to download. So for me in Firefox, I click on the link here and I can see how fast it's downloading and how long it's going to take. So I'm going to pause this video and we'll continue as soon as it's done downloading. Okay, so when your file's downloaded in Firefox, at least anyway, it's located up here where the arrow is, and I have it clicked on to see the status of it. And typically you would click on the file to open it, or you could click on the folder icon beside it to open the location. Let's click on the file itself and see what happens when launching it. Now this comes up with a map drive and shows us the contents of the disk, which is pretty cool, but we don't want that. This is not very helpful to us. So what we want to do, if we close out of here, go back in here and click the folder, we can see where it's been downloaded. Now there's two ways of burning the image. One is to right click on it here and burn the disk image, and that would be good if you have a CD. In my case, I don't have a CD drive, so I can't choose that. Otherwise I could just choose the CD or DVD drive from the drop down menu and hit burn. It'll burn the disk and we got that. But instead, I don't have a CD drive and I want to burn it to a USB stick instead anyway. So what I want to do, I'm going to close this, and I need another program for burning this. So let's have a look at that. In a case like mine where I don't have a CD drive, I could plug in a USB external CD drive and burn a CD from there, but I want to use a USB. So I need to download another tool. And here, if you go to pendrivelinux.com, you'll be able to download this program called Yumi. Now they had a standalone version and they got one that's a multi-boot, and Yumi allows you to install multiple ISO files on a single USB stick. So whether you want to install just one or multiple, this is awesome. So I would recommend using Yumi. And so from here we're scrolling down on their page. Now let me just, I kind of jumped ahead, so from the home page there's the recently updated USB Linux posts, USB creator. So Yumi multi-boot USB creator. It's also on the side menu here for their latest posts. They've got the multi-boot creator, and so if we scroll down here, there's download Yumi and it has the latest version. I've already got it downloaded, so we're gonna skip ahead. When you have the file downloaded, it doesn't really have an install. When you launch it, you have to agree to run it, agree, and it launches the program. So here you get to select the drive letter of your USB device. So I've got this one here prepared, and you can tell it to format it just to be sure that it's going to be clean. And from option 2, you want to select the distribution that we're installing. And even though it's Linux, they do have Windows on here as well. So there's the different types of Ubuntu and Linux, CentOS, Puppy, there's all kinds. And then there's other distros, a whole bunch of them. And there's other tools, antivirus tools, system tools. It just gets into a whole bunch of different things here. So you can experiment with this. we want Xubuntu. This is the one that we downloaded, so I'm going to choose that. And once I've got my distribution selected, now actually from here it gives you a link to their homepage so that you can then go and download the latest version of that distribution. But I've already got it, so I'm going to browse and find my ISO file. So it's got my ISO file in here, and we don't need to change anything else, so I'm going to create, and it gives you a bit of information here. So any information that you have on that drive is going to get wiped because we're stalling an ISO file. So when you hit yes to continue, it starts to prepare that file and install it in a way that the disk is going to be bootable and we'll be able to perform our next steps. So this can take a while because the image files for these programs are usually several gigs in size. So I'm going to pause the video again and okay, and then when it's done, it tells you the process is complete and you can hit next. And it asks you if you would like to add any more ISOs or distributions of Linux on here now. So you can do one after another. So you could have a bunch of different versions of Linux downloaded ahead of time, all the ISO files lined up, ready to go, hit yes, and then add in the next one and the next one, and just following the process over and over, adding as many as your USB stick can handle. I'm going to say no and finish, and that's it. We've got the file. So my USB file now shows multi-boot, and there's a file folder called multi-boot, and in there it has a bunch of files that allow this to be a bootable system, and it's got my one ISO file extracted here. So the menu is there, which allows us to choose what we want when we're booting from that, and it would point to the appropriate folder. In this case, it's going to point to our Xubuntu, and there's the ISO file, and it mounts it and it's able to run it right from there. So that's it basically for creating a bootable USB drive, which is actually pretty cool because with this Yumi program by Linux, or PenDrive Linux, is actually able to have more than one ISO file on here. So although we didn't need to use another file or program to download a torrent file and extracting the torrent before even getting to the ISO, this would be requiring a whole other program. We only needed to get one program for burning the ISO file to a USB stick. So again, if you were burning it to a CD or a DVD, you wouldn't need to get the PenDrive Linux or any other kind of USB bootable program. You could just right-click on it and say burn the image. So that's it for this video. If you guys wanted to see how to actually boot from the thing, you can check out my other video up here, which I will link to, that will tell you how to boot from it and run Linux. So thanks for watching. Give it a thumbs up if you enjoyed the video, if you found it helpful. Subscribe if you haven't already, and stay tuned for future updates. And your suggestions and comments are greatly appreciated and help me pump out more helpful tech-torials for you guys. All right, thanks so much, and we will see you in the next one. Bye for now.